mathematics may not teach you how to add happiness in your life, or it may not teach you how to subtract sadness from your life, but it teaches one very important thing, that every problem has a solution. Mind it, every problem has a solution. With this, we'll solve exercise 2.2 from Triangles chapter. These are the questions based on BPT and corollary, which you know very well. If you know that BPT and its corollary, then all the problem becomes very easy. Now see that the first problem of exercise 2.2, in figure 2.17, this is the figure. First and second problem is there. DE is parallel to BC. In both the cases, first problem, ABC is the triangle, and in the second problem, ABC is the triangle. In both the cases, DE is parallel to BC. When a line is parallel to BC, you know rest of the things based on BPT. Find EC. In case 1, find EC. This EC length we have to find. Find EC. And AD into AD. AD we have to find in the second case. Understand, children? Understand question properly. So, in these triangles, ABC, ABC, DE is parallel. In both the cases, DE is parallel. Now, recall BPT, basic proportional theorem. A line drawn parallel to one of the sides of the triangle divides other two sides in the equal ratio. Now, based on BPT. BPT, according to that, what is that? DE, if any one line is parallel to, if a line parallel to one of the sides, then other two sides, which are the other two sides? AB and AC. This particular line divides other two sides in equal ratio. What do you mean by that? AD by BD is equals to AE by EC. This is from BPT. If a line is parallel. This is first problem. What are the things given here? AD. What is AD? AD is equals to 1.5 centimeter. What is BD or DB? Both one same. BD is equals to 3 centimeter. AE 1 centimeter. And what we need to find is EC or CE. We need to find. Just substitute all this value in this, so that 1.5 in place of AD, 1.5, BD is equal to 3 centimeter, AE is 1 by EC, we don't know, we have to find. Just reciprocate it. After reciprocating, you get 3 by 1.5 is equals to EC by 1. Now you can see that it's very clear that 1.5 two times is 3. Therefore, 2 is equals to EC, or EC is equals to 2 centimeter. EC is equals to 2 centimeter. How we got this? We got by BPT, basic proportionality theorem. Very easily we applied. Basic proportionality theorem said that if a line drawn parallel to one of the sides of the triangle to intersect other two sides at two distinct points, then other two sides are divided in the equal ratio. This is what the statement. So we have used that and substituted whatever the given value, we have got EC is equals to 2 centimeter. In the second case, same, apply basic proportional theorem. After applying, you'll get AD, see properly, AD by BD is equals to AE by EC. AE by EC. Now R BC R CE. What is the value AD? We don't know. We have to find AD. We don't know. We need to find that. What is BD? BD is equals to 7.2 centimeter. AE 1.8 centimeter. EC or CE 5.4 centimeter. Just substitute all the values. AD we don't have, keep as it is. BD is 7.2 centimeter. What is AE? 1.8 divided by EC 5.4. We want to find AD. So transfer this 7.2 other side. How? By multiplying and dividing 7 by 2 both the sides. Right hand side. 1.8 5.4 into, after multiplying and dividing by 7.2, so this is transferred other side. Now observe properly, after this decimal, how many digits are there? This is the decimal. How many digits are there to convert this decimals into a whole number? You have to see that this decimal, after decimal, how many digits are there? Maximum number of digits is the count. So here in both the cases, after decimal, one digit are there. Therefore, multiply and divide by 10 so that easily this can be removed. If after decimal two digits are there, maximum count, then 100, multiply and divide by 100. If it is 3 digit, then multiply and divide by 1000. Now I multiply and divide by 10 so that to remove this decimal and division becomes easy. 1.8 by 5.4 into 10 to 10. 7.2, keep as it is. Multiply this. 1.8 into 10 is 18. 5.4 into 10 is 54 into 7.2. These two, 18 and 54, are the multiples of 9. 9, 2 times, 9, 6 times. And thus, AD is equals to 2 by 6 into 7.2. 2 by 6 into 7.2. Now, AD is equals to 2.6. Now I am going to change this, convert this decimal into whole number. How? By multiplying and dividing by 10. Why? Because after this decimal, this one, we have only one digit. So 7.2 into 10 by 10. AD is equals to 2 by 6. 7.2 into 10 is 72. 10 keep as it is. 6, 12 times. 6, 12 times is 72. For AD is equals to 2 into 12 by 10. AD is equals to 24 by 10. AD is equals to 2.4 centimeter. What is the value? 2.4 centimeter. Here AC is equals to 2 centimeters. Understood? So very, very easy. BPT, all this, some 15-16 problems are there in exercise 2.2. So in all these things we are going to apply basic proportionality theorem concept and its corollary, and one more is there, converse. We will teach you that, don't worry. Now we will enter into second problem. Now we will see the second question of exercise 2.2. It says E and F are points on the sides PQ and PR respectively of a triangle PQR. PQR triangle is written in three cases are there. 1, 2, 3. Three cases. In all the three cases, triangle is written. What is the triangle? PQR. What is the E and F? E and F are the points on the sides PQ and PR. PQ and PR. Okay. So E is a point on PQ and F is a point on PR respectively. E and F are the points on the sides PQ and PR respectively. In all the cases you can observe E and F. E and F are the points on PQ and PR. PQ and PR of the triangle PQR. For each of the following cases, for each of the following cases, how many cases are there? Case 1, case 2, case 3. Case 1 diagram, case 2 and case 3. Okay. State whether EF is parallel to QR. Whether EF is parallel to QR, we have to state. Okay. Now, how will you state whether EF is parallel to QR? You must know the converse of BPT. Converse of BPT. What is this converse of BPT? To know the converse of BPT, you must know what is BPT, basic proportionality theorem. Basic proportionality theorem, for example, I'll take here the same triangle PQR. PQR. And think this EF is parallel already. By basic proportionality theorem, if a line, EF is a line, if a line drawn parallel to one of the sides of the triangle divides other two sides in the equal ratio. Basic proportionality theorem starts with a line parallel to one of the sides of the triangle. If it is parallel, then it divides other two sides, in the equal ratio or proportionally. PE by EQ is equals to PF by FR or RF. If a line is parallel to a side of a triangle, divides other two sides in the equal ratio, starting with parallel and ending with dividing other two sides in the equal ratio. It comes like this. But converse of the BPT starts with divides other two sides in the equal ratio, then the line is parallel. What does this converse state? If a line drawn divides other two sides in the equal ratio or proportionally, if this line drawn to one of the sides of the triangle divides other two sides in the equal ratio, then the line is parallel to third side. This is just a reverse of this BPT. BPT starting with parallel lines and ending with divides other two sides in the equal ratio. Here, divides other two sides in the equal ratio, then the line can be considered as the parallel lines. If it is parallel line only, it divides other two sides in the equal ratio. If it divides other two sides in the equal ratio, then the line must be the parallel. This is the condition we take in one case. Okay. So if it proves that other two sides are dividing the equal ratio, that is PE by PQ. PE by PQ. E is equals to PF by FR, then we will say that EF is parallel. If it is not equal, if PE by EQ is not equals to PF by FR, then we say that then EF is not parallel. EF is not parallel to QR. Understand properly. This is converse. And corollary also you have to apply. What is that corollary that you are going to apply? The corollary exactly same. In corollary, you are considering two triangles, that is defined triangle. A line drawn to one of the sides of the triangle, a parallel line drawn one of the sides of the triangle, divides the corresponding sides of the two triangles. You can see that PEF is one triangle, that is a defined triangle after writing this line EF. And PQR are the original triangle. They two are similar. P PEF and PQR are the similar triangles. If they are similar, then their angles, corresponding angles are equal and their corresponding sides divided in the equals. Which are the corresponding sides? This is according to corollary. Corollary of BPT. Just know what is explained. This is converse of BPT. Converse of BPT is same as that of BPT where the reverse order of the BPT. But corollary, in corollary, you are considering two triangles, that is PEF and PQR. So their corresponding sides, for example, PQ by PE is equals to PR by PF. If this is the case, if corresponding sides divide in the equal ratio, then the line must be EF is parallel to QR. Both the cases, don't confuse. Here two sides, here considering only in the converse and BPT, considering only one triangle, and this particular EF as just a line which divides other two sides in the equal ratio. CL PE by EQ, sorry, PE by EQ is equal to PF by FR. Okay, so here considering only one triangle, but in corollary we are considering two triangles, that is PEF and PQR. These two triangles, different triangle and original triangle, are similar. When they are similar, their corresponding sides are proportional. If their corresponding sides are proportional, then EF must be parallel to QR. EF must be parallel to QR by corollary. If we prove that PQ by PE is equals to PR by PF, then EF must be parallel to QR. If it is not equal, then it is not parallel. This concept we are going to apply. Okay, so therefore this concept, learn properly. This 1, 2, 3 questions becomes very, very easy. Understand this. Now I am going to apply this concept to these problems. See the case 1 and triangle here. Triangle constructed. PE is equals to 3.9 cm. PE is equals to 3.9 cm written. EQ is equals to 3 cm. PF 3.6 cm and FR is 2.4 cm. Now, with all this data, we have to state whether EF is parallel to QR, whether or not EF is parallel to QR. How you state now, if in this triangle, consider this triangle, if what are the data given? PE is equals to 3.9. EQ, RQ is equals to 3 cm. PF is equals to 3.6 cm. Then FR is equals to 2.4 cm. Now by converse of the basic proportionality theorem, if PE by converse of BPT, converse of BPT, PE divided by EQ, if it is equals to PF by FR, then we can say EF is parallel to QR. Now we'll see that. First we'll take PE by EQ, whether or not equal or not. What is PE? PE is 3.9. By what is EQ? 3. This is nothing but 3 × 1 × 3 × 3 × 3 × 3 × 3 × 3 × 3 × 3 × 3 × 3 × 3 × 3 × 3 × 3 × 3 × 3 × 3 × 3 × 3 × 3 × 3 × 3 × 3 × 3 × 3 × 3 × 3 × 3 × 3 × 3 × 3 × 3 × 3 × 3 × 3 × 3 × 3 × 3 × 3 × 3 × 3 × 3 × 3 × 3 × 3 × 3 × 3 × 3 × 3 × 3 × 3 × 3 × 3 × 3 × 3 × 3 × 3 × 3 × 3 × 3 × 3 × 3 × 3 × 3 × 3 × 3 × 3 × 3 × 3 × 3 × 3 × 3 × 3 × 3 × 3 × 3 × 3 × 3 × 3 × 3 × 3 × 3 × 3 × 3 × 3 × 3 × 3 × 3 × 3 × 3 × 3 × 3 × 3 × 3 × by EQ is equals to 1.3 centimeters. If we get PF by FR also 1.3 centimeters, then PE by EQ becomes equals to PF by FR. Then we can say that EF is parallel to QR. Now we see what is the value of PF by FR. What is PF? PF is 3.6. FR 2.4. Okay, convert decimal into whole. You convert decimal into whole, multiply by 10, it becomes 36 by 24. Okay, 12, 3 times, 12, 2 times, that is 3 by 2. PF by FR is equal to 3 by 2. 3 by 2 is nothing but 1.5 centimeter. 3 by 2 is nothing but 1.5 centimeter. Now you see that PE by EQ is 1.3 centimeter and PF by FR is equal to 1.5 centimeter. Are they equal? Are they equal? They are not equal. They are not equal. Therefore, EF is not parallel to QR. In first case, EF is not parallel to. What is asked to state whether EF is parallel to QR. EF is not parallel to QR. Why EF is not parallel to QR? Because by the converse of the BPT, we did not get this condition. What condition? PE by EQ is not become equal to PF by FR. If it become equal, then parallel, not become equal. PE by EF is 1.3, PF by FR is 1.5. Therefore, in the first case, it is not equal. We'll see, sorry, since it is not equal, so EF is not parallel to QR. Let's see the second case. Now we'll see the second case. In second case, PE is equal to 4 cm, QE is equal to 4.5 cm, PF is equal to 8 cm and RF is equal to 9 cm. The diagram is written here. Observe properly. PE 4 cm, EQ 4.5, PF 8 cm and RF 9 cm. Now, what we need to do is, as usual, whether EF is parallel to QR, we have to show. So, EF becomes parallel to QR only when PE divided by EQ is equals to PF divided by FR. FR and RF are same. Now we see that. Take into consideration PE by EQ. What is PE? PE is 4 cm substitute. 4 cm. What is EQ? EQ is 4.5 cm. 4.5 cm. Okay. After this decimal, one digit is there. So multiply and divide both by 10. So that you will get 40 by 45. Both are the multiples of 5. So that 5 8 times, 5 9 times. You got PE by EQ is equal to 8 by 9. Keep it. And mark this as 1. Now you take PF by FR. PF by FR. What is PF? PF is 8 cm. And RF or FR is 9 cm. Direct substitution, you can see that. No calculation, nothing. Directly we got 8 by 9. PE by EQ also 8 by 9 and PF by FR also 8 by 9. Thus, PE by EQ is equals to PF by FR and therefore EF is parallel to QR. In the second case, by the converse of BPT, we have got PE by EQ is equals to, you can see that PE by EQ is 8 by 9. In this case also, PF by FR is 8 by 9. In both the case, 8 by 9, 8 by 9. So that we declare that PE by EQ is equals to PF by FR. If it is equals to, then what is the condition? EF is parallel to QR. In the second case, EF is parallel to QR. Now we'll see the third problem. Now we'll see the third case, whether EF is parallel to QR or not by, now this particular thing you should know, corollary of BPT. Corollary of BPT, you know everything, what is corollary of everything. So based on that, we are going to prove now that EF, whether or not EF is parallel to QR. Now consider this point PQ. What is PQ? PQ is 1.28 centimeter. PR is equals to 2.56 centimeter. PE is equals to 0.18 centimeter, and PF is equals to 0.36 centimeter. Now see that PQ is a hole and PE corollary, if you apply corollary only, converse and BPT will not do it. What is the corollary? Two triangles are there, that is PEF is a defined triangle and original triangle is PQR. These two PEF triangle, PEF and triangle, original triangle PQR. Okay, so they are, if they are similar by the corollary, then PQ by PE is equals to PR by PF. If this particular line, corollary states that if a line drawn parallel to one of the sides of the triangle, then the line defines a new triangle PEF. This new triangle will be equals to the original triangle PQR. If not equal, similar to PQR. If PQR is similar to PEF, what is the condition? The corresponding sides divides in the equal ratio. If the corresponding sides divides in the equal ratio, then what is the meaning? EF is parallel to QR. Now corresponding sides divides in the equal ratio written. Whether it divides or not, we will see. Consider PQ by EF. What is PQ? 1.28. What is PE? 0.18. Okay. After this decimal, how many digits is there? Two digits. Here, as a two. So divide both sides by, and multiply by 100, so that you will get 1.28.18 into 100 by 100. This means PQ by EF, PQ by PE is equals to 128 by 18. Keep as it is and mark this as 1. Now take this one. PR by PF is equals to, what is PR? 2.56 centimeter. What is PF? 0.36. As usual, after decimal you have got two digits, so multiply and divide by 100. Thus you will get 256 by 36. Both could be divided by 2, such that 128 by 18. After dividing 256 by 2, you will get 128. By dividing 36 by 2, you will get 18. Observe properly. Mark this as 2. PQ by PE, you got 128 by 18. And PR by PF, also you got 128 by 18. What does it mean? It means that PQ by PE is equals to PR by PF. If the corresponding sides divides in the equal ratio, here it is dividing in the equal ratio. What does it mean? It means EF is parallel to, EF is parallel to QR. EF is parallel to QR. I have considered here EF is parallel to QR. Why? Because by the corollary of BPT, corresponding sides divides in the equal ratio, then EF is parallel to QR. EF is parallel to QR. EF written parallel to QR defines a new triangle PEF, which is similar to the original triangle PQR. Similar means corresponding sides divides in the equal ratio. So it is actually dividing in the equal ratio, meaning EF is parallel to UR. Did you understand, children? Now we'll enter into one more third problem.
Done, sir.
Now we'll see the third problem of exercise 2.2. So it says that in figure 2.18, this is the figure given, 2.18, if LM, see properly, LM is parallel to CB, LM is parallel to CB and LN is parallel to CD, LM is parallel to CB and LN parallel to CD, prove that AM by AB is equals to AM by AB is equals to AN by AD, AN by AD. Now, if you know corollary of basic proportionality theorem, this could be proved very, very easily. Now consider, I have split this one diagram into two, so that two triangles we are getting. In this one diagram, two triangles is merged. I have split here. See, A, B, C, one triangle where LM is parallel to CB, and one more triangle A, D, C. A, D, C. In this, LN is parallel to CD. Now consider this. Consider triangle A, B, C. Consider triangle A, B, C where LM is parallel to CB. When LM is parallel to CB, if a line is parallel to one of the sides of the triangle, then by corollary, you know that corresponding sides divided in the equal ratio. Which are the corresponding sides? AC by AL is equals to AB by AM. Mark this as one. This we have derived from this triangle where we applied corollary concept, corollary of BPT. Can you see that? Here also two triangles are there, defined and original. So we have taken corresponding sides divides in the equal ratio. In that concept, AB by AM is equals to AC by AL. Now consider the second triangle which we have split here in triangle ABC. ADC where LN is parallel to CD. LN is parallel to CD. Here also you can see that two triangles inside, one defined triangle as well as the original triangle. So take corresponding sides in the equal ratio. Why? Because LN is parallel to CD. LN is parallel to CD. Based on that we get AC by AL is equals to AD by AN. Mark this as 2. We have got this from this triangle and this from the one which we have split from this 2.18. If you consider properly, see properly, AC by AL is equals to AB by AM and AC by AL is also equals to AD by AM. This AC from 1, AC by AL is equals to AB by AM and AC by AL is also equals to AD by AM. Therefore, AB by AM is equals to, since AC by AM is equals to both AB by AM and as well as AD by AN, thus AB by AM is equals to AD by AN, which is what asked and we have proved. Just reciprocate it, you will get AM by AB is equals to AN by AD. This is what asked and we approved, where we have applied corollary of basic proportionality theorem. Did you understand, children? If you have any doubts, you post your doubts, we'll clarify in the further videos. In the next video, we'll see the fourth problem. Bye bye, children.